Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, and in this video we will see how we can use serial port communication in Python. So what we have here is a device. It's a nodemcu device. So this nodemcu device is actually sending some data as a string to a Python code base, to my computer, using serial port communication. And we'll write a Python code which will simply read the data, and that's it. Now, why serial port communication is needed is simply because of there are multiple reasons for that. The first being is that there are multiple sensors that are available which is dependent on serial port communication, and a host computer always needs to communicate with these sensors to get the data using the same. The serial port communication is usually done over UART, what we call as universal asynchronous receiver transmitter. And today we will simply implement a Python code base. It's a very simple one through which we can read the incoming data that is available over serial port communication. So let's get started without wasting any more time. So we are gonna use a particular module called PySerial. It's a Python module. So firstly, what we'll do is simply install it using the PIP package manager as always. So let me bring up Visual Studio Code. PIP install PySerial. Since in my case it is already installed, that's where we're gonna skip it. So to use the PySerial library, we'll firstly import the package whose name is serial. Then we'll define instantiate the serial class. Before going all that, let me tell you how do you basically figure out where the device is connected to. So Python PySerial, basically the package, does provide a sample code which helps us to figure out what devices are connected to the computer, and also display as a list the names of those ports. So for Windows, you can use Device Manager to get an overview about whatever devices are connected and in which port it is connected. For Linux kernel based systems, you can use this tool as well, or you can use the traditional way of doing ls under your /dev directory. So what they have provided is serial.tools.list_ports. So if your PySerial is already installed, then this command will simply work out. As I execute this particular code base, which is a part of the library, you see that two ports are already displayed. The first one I'm not interested, I'm interested in a second one, because that is where my nodemcu is connected. So when we are creating an object, we'll just name it as ACR, is equals to serial, that's the name of the method, And within parentheses, we are going to pass the name of the port. In both the OSs, it's the name of the port. Here it is available as /dev/TTYY, etc. But in case of Windows, it will be available as something like com followed by a number. So it's a named parameter. So port is equals to this, comma, and then we'll be passing the baud rate, which will be is equals to 9600, because that is what we have set in the device. Next, we'll simply define an infinite while loop. You can also define a for loop as well. Basically, we need an infinite loop because I want it to scan always, keep on scanning. Whenever the data is available, just simply print it. So here I'll just simply get the raw value, which is is equals to the object that we have defined, acr.readline. So essentially what it will do is that it will simply get the value, whatever is available, up to a new line in bytes format. So what I will do is simply convert this into string. Value in string is equals to str value, and the format is UTF-8, so that also I'm gonna mention, so decoding will be much more simpler. and here I'm gonna print value string. So yeah, that's it. That's the simple implementation of reading the data from an available device. It's as simple as it can get. So let me simply run this code, python read.py. And here I am receiving the message as all okay, which is essentially the same message that I'm printing over here. I mean, whatever I'm sending over here. So I'm gonna just modify this and just mention it as I am working. You can move ahead. I'm going to upload this piece of code into my nodemcu. Sometimes it might take a bit of time. So whenever I'm uploading the code base, since this application is also uploading the code using the same serial port communication, using the same COM port, and that's why this the Python script will get disconnected. So at a single point of time, only a single application can get access to the serial port. So it has been uploaded. The device, I think it's working. So I'm gonna run the code again. And here, I am working, you can move ahead. So simply, we know that this works, and this is how you can get that particular value. You can also write values to the serial port. I'm gonna show it in you in another video, how you can actually control the device. We'll show you both the Python side of it and the Arduino side of it, or any device as a matter of fact. And you can simply write in values which will control, which will perform some action on your device, like switching on an LED or a buzzer, switching on an infrared sensor, something of that sort. So in order to simply write some values, we need to just use, sorry, caps was on, acr.write, and simply pass on whatever you want to send. So that's how simple it is. I'm not going to show the write over here, but yeah, reading is pretty straightforward. Nothing is there, nothing complicated. And it is used a lot of places, starting from M2M communication to communication between a device to the computer, to controlling a device from a computer, probably making a robot for it. So multiple things are possible. And in the industry, many places this technique is being used. For example, like the cellular modems, those communicate to the computer. I mean, to say not the laptop computer, but to the device which is actually using the using that modem, like an Arduino or Raspberry Pi, using serial port communication. That happens through UART. So this is pretty common in the world of IoT, and I hope this made some sense. Thanks for watching this video. It's pretty simple as you get it. Just 8 lines of code, not even that. So do share the feedback. I hope you like this video. Let me know in the comment section. And do subscribe to my channel. I'll again see you in another video. And I not yet decided what topic will be, but I am planning that I'll be showing you how to use serial port communication to control a device, like switch off and on and off an LED using serial port communication is in a similar code base. So that will target of next week, I guess. Till then, enjoy and have a great day. Thank you.